Good morning, students. Now this is about the topic distance between two points, and this is part one. So for those who have not seen or watched the part one, I recommend you to first watch part one, then come to this part two, because this is a continuation from the first part. Now in the first part, we have seen that from our first lesson, we know that whenever you have a point on x-axis or on a line parallel to x-axis, their y coordinates are equal. So in general, we write their coordinates as x1, y, x2, y, x3, y and so on, where y is a constant for any line parallel to the x-axis. Now in general, if the points are on the x-axis, then y coordinates are equal. So in order to calculate the distance between the two points, we just have to calculate the difference of the two x coordinates, and we have to take their absolute value. And we have discussed the significance of taking x absolute value in the previous lesson. So to eliminate the sign, we'll take that absolute value. But so when you get the difference as a -5, we have to take its absolute value, you will get 5. So distance cannot be negative. So now in this class, we'll discuss how to find the distance between two points which are on either y axis or on a line parallel to the y-axis. Let us see how we calculate this distance using some examples. So if you have followed the first part, then it's very simple for you to follow this second one. So now we have taken two points which are on the y-axis, namely A and B. Tell me the coordinates of A. As the points are on y-axis, then their x-coordinate should be zeros. So here their coordinates are A is equal to 0, 2, and the coordinates of B are 0 and 6. Now we have to find the distance between these two points. Now tell me where these points are on the coordinate plane. Exactly, these points are on the y-axis because their x-coordinates are equal. Now we have to find the distance between them, distance between A and B. Now you calculate just by counting the units from A to B. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the distance between the two points A and B is 4 units. Now we'll take another example. Now here we have taken points C and D. What are the coordinates of C? Exactly, they are 3 and 1. And what are the coordinates of D? Correct, they are 3 and 4. Now when you join these two points, we have a straight line parallel to the y-axis. Because their x-coordinates are equal, when you join the two points, you will get a straight line parallel to the y-axis. Now we have to find the distance between these two points from C to D. These two points, as we observe, these two points are on a line parallel to the y-axis. Now count the units from C to D. This is 1, 2 and 3. So the distance between C and D is 3 units. We'll take one more example. Now I have taken two points A and B. A is in which quadrant? Correct, A is in second quadrant. And where is B? B is in the third quadrant. So now the coordinates of A are -5 and 3, because it is in quadrant 2. And the coordinates of B are -5 and -3, because they are in the third quadrant. Now we have to find the distance between these two points. If you join these two points, again we got a straight line parallel to the y-axis. Now how much is B far from A? You count the units, number, you count the number of units, then you'll get the distance. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Correct. So the distance between the points A and B is 6. Instead of counting the units, we can find the distance between these two points by using the coordinates. In the first part, we have seen how to calculate the distance between two parts when the points are either on the x-axis or on a line parallel to the x-axis. Here we are taking the example of two points by joining whom we get a line parallel to the y-axis. Now you look at the y-coordinates here. Because the x-coordinates are equal, now you find the distance between these two. -3, -3. So you will have -6. As we discussed in the first part, you have to take its absolute value. What is the absolute value of -6? Very good, it is 6. So the distance from A to B is 6, which we can see from this graph also. So the distance between the points K and L. Sorry, here we have taken A and B. By mistake, I have written it as K and L. Take it as A and B. The difference between the two Y coordinates. Now here we have taken two more points. Where the points are on? Now they are in the fourth quadrant. Now the coordinates of K are 2, negative 1. And the coordinates of L are 2, 1, minus 6. Now if you join them, once again you will get a straight line parallel to the Y axis. Now what is the distance between these two? This is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now let us find this by subtracting the Y coordinates. Let us subtract minus 1 from 6. Minus 6, minus of minus 1, which will give you minus 6 plus 1. And minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5. When you take the absolute value, you will have 5. So the distance between the points K and L is 5. So when you have two points either on the Y axis or on a straight line parallel to the Y axis, now what is that you have to do to find the distance between them? Yes, you have to find the difference of the two Y coordinates. So here the distance between the points K, L, L is absolute value of the distance between difference of the two Y coordinates. You should not forget to take the absolute value because the distance cannot be negative. So let us conclude or let us draw the conclusion from this. For points either on y-axis or any line parallel to y-axis, their x-coordinates are equal. We have already seen this and we already know this from our experience. Then we can write these points as x1, y, xy1 and xy2. So their y-coordinates are different. In particular, x-values are 0 for any line parallel to the, for any point on the y-axis. Now you to find the distance between these two, you have to find the difference of these two coordinates, which will give you y2 minus y1. As we already know, we have to take the absolute value. So the distance between the two points is modulus of y2 minus y1. So from the first part, we have seen that when the two points are either on the x-axis or on a line parallel to the x-axis, you have to take the difference of x-coordinates. For points on the y-axis or any line parallel to the y-axis, you have to take the difference of the y-coordinates. So you remember these two? We use this formula when the points are on the x-axis or any line parallel to the x-axis. That is, when their y-coordinates are equal. When the x-coordinates are equal, we use this formula to calculate the distance between the two points. Let us solve an example so that we can reinforce this concept. Here we have taken two points, S and T. S is 0,4. T is 0,3. Their x-coordinates are equal, so which means they are on the y-axis. Now we find the different distance between them using modulus of y2 minus y1. Here y1 is 4, y2 is negative 3. So y2 minus y1, minus 3 minus 4, which you have minus 7. We have to take the absolute value of it. It is 7. Now look at this example. Here we have taken two points, 2, negative 5c and 2, negative 3, which is d. Now their x coordinates are equal. So they are on a line parallel to the y axis. Now how much is y1 here? Very good, 2. How much is y2? Nice, y minus 3. So you have to find the difference of these two, which is minus 3 minus of minus 5. So minus of minus 5 is plus 5, we know this. So minus 3 plus 5 is 2, and we know the absolute value of 2 is again 2. So that is how you find the distance between two points either on the y-axis or on any line parallel to the y-axis. How can we identify them? If their x-coordinates are equal, that's it. You have to use this formula, modulus of y2 minus y1, that is difference of the two y coordinates. Now I'll give you some problems for you to solve. You solve them and post them as usual. Here we have taken different line segments. There are 6 line segments. You have to find the distances between them. You need not use a formula. Just by looking at the graph, you can tell the answer. You write the answer and post it to me. And then I have given 4 different problems here. You have to calculate the distance between these two problems using the formula. Thank you.